everyone, welcome to the brand new episode of our monthly art tutorials. Look, I'm a bird today. Anyways, jokes apart, before we get started with our how-to tutorial from start to finish that of course you're going to watch further, I wanted to let you know how happy I am that finally I have your submissions from you, paintings that you have done from your side, and I'm so happy to see that you are actually able to learn from my teachings and tutorials. Janet had a bit problems here and there with her shading technique, but Janet, I'm there and I am going to show one more video sometimes later in the month or next month. I'll teach you again how to use the paints that you are having problem with, so don't worry at all. But you did a great job with your painting, and Robin, you incorporated your own techniques into the painting, and I was so happy to see that, you know, although you were learning from my ideas and although you were you incorporated a lot of what I taught, but you had an identity of your own as well in the painting, and I was so happy to see that, because in the end when I am teaching you, my ultimate goal is I want you to be able to paint an original after each and every painting that I teach you. Now that's my ultimate goal, so I was very happy to see that you were able to not only take my techniques, but you were able to incorporate your own twist or in your own personality to the painting. So that was great, and I got this amazing Buddha drawing from Annette as well. So you three people are the main competitors of the giveaway that I am giving away in this episode. So stay tuned till the end to see who won our Buddha bag. So now let's get started with today's tutorial. That is a journal cover that we are going to paint from start to finish. But before I show you the complete process of how to paint the entire cover of the journal that we are going to paint further, I want to tell you one thing that I had announced on my Patreon Facebook page, that I am taking this tutorial to the next level. And by the next level, I don't mean that, you know, I'm going to make the techniques all the more difficult, or, you know, I'm going to make this painting all the more difficult. No, in fact, I have taken taken the process of this painting one step down, like one step below the how difficult the Buddha painting was, one step below how difficult the girl with the roses was. So, because in this tutorial I want you to think on your own, and you know, I want you to experiment that with the techniques that you have already learned from the previous two tutorials. The thing that I was saying that I have taken it to a next level, I was saying that because in this tutorial I'm not giving away each and everything. Like, you will not find this drawing of the sunflowers that are there on the drawing, you will not find those sunflowers as a PDF given just ready made to you. I am showing you in very slow motion, and I have selected very easy drawing so that you are able to draw along with me as and when I am showing you. You know, when you're watching this tutorial, just, you know, keep a journal pen and a pencil or a rubber and a sharpener with you, so you don't get up in between this tutorial. So I want you to, you know, play along with me, so that I have created the drawing in a very easy way, and the drawing of the bird also in a very easy way. So I'm not giving away any drawings. I know all of you are absolutely amazing and you can do this, so I want you to experiment a lot. So that's why this tutorial is to the next level, because this is not a baby feeding. Like, I'm not giving away each and every thing, like all the colors and all the drawings, and you just have to pick up that and put it on and just copy it. No, you have to think this time. I'm just giving you basic instructions, and you have to follow those basic instructions. Even, you know, and even those basic instructions are very clear, and you know, I'm of course giving away a lot in that as well, but at the same time I want you to understand, look at the colors and understand them, and you know, I want you to find colors from your own collection and from your whatever you have, I want you to find colors from that and experiment with that. You will understand what I'm saying as you go through the tutorial. So without taking any more of your time, let's get started with today's tutorial. And before getting started with the tutorial, let's just check out how exactly this journal is going to look like. So let's go ahead.
So this is the journal that we are going to make today in our tutorial video, and I really hope that you will like it and you will enjoy recreating it as much as I did making it. So let's get started. So this is the front part of the journal that you're looking at over here, and this is the back side, and this is the cord that I used to bind the complete journal. This is just a synthetic elastic thread which is mostly used for jewelry making, but I used it over here to bind our journal. And these are some extra clips that I may need in my journal, so I have just tucked them all over there. So as you open the journal, the first thing that you see is a little envelope that I have stuck over here that I'm going to show you further how I did it. And it has a closure made out of embroidery floss, and in that little envelope I have some sticky notes and some little star stickers, as you can see over here. You can even use the envelopes to keep your little pen and a pencil inside it, as shown. So the first pages in this journal are made out of regular sketching paper. This is the thick sketching paper. The first part of my journal I decided to use for mostly sketching and, you know, rough sketches and stuff like that. So the first part is for that, and I have used this clip, you know, as a little closure for this part of the journal, and it even keeps this part of the pages or this part of the journal separated from the other two parts of this journal. You'll see how what I'm talking about as we go further in the video. So here is a little divider that is just, you know, nothing but a designer paper sheet, nothing else. I just, you know, put it over there to use it as a little divider, you know, nothing fancy or nothing special. And the next part of the journal is made out of some really amazing watercolor paper that I had, because this part I wanted to use, you know, for actually putting on paints on paper and just you know, for playing around with paints and stuff. And even this part is held together by a little clip, as you can see. And then last but not the least, the last part is made up of regular writing paper, you know, this ruled writing paper that you can see. I had a spare notebook which I was not using anymore, so these pages were just torn out of that, and I put it over here in this journal. And again, even these pages are held together by this little clip. So, you know, the first part is for sketching, the second part is for putting on paints, and the third part is for some planning and writing notes and all that stuff like that. So this covers my entire journal, and this is exactly what I wanted from this journal. I wanted to actually cover all three parts. Like, I wanted to be able to do sketching on what the kind of paper that I like, and in the same journal I even wanted to play around with paints, and if I wanted to write some notes or some thoughts, I have space for that as well. So isn't it an absolutely cool and amazing journal? So, you know, let's get started with how I made it. But first and most important, let's get started with how I painted the cover of this journal. So
now you've seen the complete journal of how it looks and how it is and all that stuff, let's move on with the complete tutorial of how I painted the cover of it and what was I exactly thinking with it.
Let's go ahead. So for making this journal cover, first what we are going to need is this artist canvas pad. So artist canvas pad is basically a kind of sketchbook or coloring book, or, you know, whatever you want to call it. It's kind of a book that is made out of blank canvases, just like a regular sketchbook that is made out of regular paper or regular sketchbook. This is just another book for sketching and coloring and all that stuff, but it is made out of canvas cloth. So we will need this book for that, and first what we're going to do is we are going to cut one canvas cloth square out of this book. Over here I did not have any scale near me, so I am just using a pencil as a reference to have a straight line so that I can just go ahead and cut the square. So as I had told you earlier that I am not going to tell you the exact colors this time. I want you to guess the shades while looking at the colors, you know. Just experiment with whatever you have in your kitty. I want you to experiment and see that what colors go well together. Of course, I am going to give you the basic gist, but I'm not going to give you the exact colors. So over here on my little canvas, I'm just spreading various shades of blue that I had in my studio. So there's turquoise blue, there's dark blue, there is another shade of blue. Basically, there are three shades of blue. And the drops of that I dropped over here on the canvas. And then I will start mixing all the blues, and to basically spread all the blues and mix them a bit with each other, what I will do is I will choose one color first, and then I will just keep spreading it all over the canvas before getting on to next color. Like, as you can see over here, I am just spreading this shade of blue, you know, this is the medium shade of blue. And I'm not spreading any other color. So when I will be done with spreading this shade, this is medium shade of blue, then I will get to, you know, mixing the next color, that is this dark blue, as you can see, and then the lightest color. So, you know, in this technique of mixing the colors, like going with mixing one color first and then going on to the next color, it keeps all the colors fresh. And they don't all mix together with each other and does just get muddy. They all just stand out, you know. When I'll complete this whole page, you will see that each and every color has its identity and it is standing out, and they are not all mixed up in each other. So this is the reason we mixed one color first and then got on to another one. And one more thing, while mixing these colors, I'm not using any water at all. Of course, if you want, you can just wipe your brush with a normal kitchen tissue, kitchen towel or anything like that, or, you know, just a regular cloth. But, you know, don't wet your brush or don't use water to mix the shades, because, you know, we don't want a smooth blend on this canvas. We just, you know, want them to mix roughly and, you know, just show some texture and show some identity over here. Of our painting is absolutely ready to work on. As you can see, it is looking a bit very plain for my taste, so I decided to add some yellow color just using my fingers here and there to you know, to lift it up a bit, because it was getting very, very plain for me. So I do not want to use any brush while spreading this yellow color. I just wanted to add some more texture, which will give the blue base that we have some more depth. So after you adding this yellow color, if you can see this complete background that we have created, it has got a bit more identity and a bit more depth, and it is looking a lot more interesting. So, you know, these are the small little tips and tricks, you know, that make a painting a lot more interesting to look at. Now imagine the same background if we would have kept it only with blue, the shades of blue, and now look at this background after we added yellow. You can yourself feel the difference that we created, the amount of personality this page has already got. So, you know, even when you are experimenting in your journals, in your sketchbook or on your canvases, do try out such little experiments and try to do such things, you know, which will make you think and which will make you actually push yourself and do things out of the box, as such experiments bring a lot of interest and fun to a regular normal painting. So over here I am just, you know, drawing some sunflowers. These are not realistic sunflowers at all. These are just my version of sunflowers, and these are the most easiest drawings ever. In this video I am not giving away the drawing, you know, just to download and copy, because you know these are so easy sunflowers that I would really want you to try to make them yourself. So I just made a circle and then added some leaves all around it one by one, and then in between those leaves I added some more little leaves, as you can see peeking out from the main leaves that I had created in the front. So I'm not speeding up the drawing of these sunflowers at all. You know, even while looking at this video right now, just, you know, I want you to pick up your sketchbook, not even a proper canvas or anything. You know, don't start painting or anything while watching this video, but just, you know, pick up a sketchbook that must be around you, or a rough paper that must be laying around you, and pick up a pencil and just, you know, start drawing this really easy and simple sunflower with me, while even I am drawing it over here with you. Then I even added some leaves here and there and some stems to the sunflower. Done drawing the drawing of our sunflower and some leaves around it, I wanted to start painting the sunflowers first. So the plan that I had in my mind before starting to paint these sunflowers is I wanted some droplets all around, you know, I wanted some droplets to be spread all around the canvas, and I wanted to paint the sunflowers over those droplets, so that I have those little droplets peeking through the sunflowers and leaves and all. So over here I am taking some pink paint for those droplets, and in this pink paint I will add a lot of water. That means if I have 30% of paint, or maybe, you know, if I have 40% of pink paint, then I will add 60% of water to it, and with a thick number 12 brush, you know, I'm just throwing the paint on all around the sunflowers and the background that we had created, you know, creating such beautiful droplets over the sunflowers. So why I used pink color is because on the background we have blue color, and for sure on the sunflowers we are going to paint with yellow color. So we already have blue and we already have yellow, so I needed one color that is contrasting to blue and yellow. So pink color was the color that came to my mind, you know, that will stand out not only with yellow but even with blue, and not only stand out, it will even look good with them. So that's why I chose this color pink. So I'm again not telling you the exact shade or exact brand of pink that I'm using. You can use whatever shade you have, but you know, that is the reason I used pink droplets all around. And just, you know, to make the droplets of the pink all the more interesting, and you know, I wanted them to pop up a bit more, what I am doing is next I'll be taking, you know, white color and spreading the white color droplets on the canvas while my pink drops are already wet. So again, for white I took 40% of the white paint, that is my white gesso, and then 60% of water with it, and as you can see I am dropping the droplets of white all around the canvas. And while I'm dropping the droplets of white all around the canvas, the colors of the pink drops are, you know, kind of getting mixed with the color, with the white color, and creating a lovely, lovely blend. So before moving on further with painting of the sunflowers, I decided to color next side, the other side of the canvas, that will be the other part of our journal. And I am painting over it a shiny iridescent blue color shade all over the other side. So isn't this back side looking so awesome and so shiny and beautiful? So now that we are done with the back side as well as the background for our sunflowers, let's get started with the painting of our sunflowers. So as you must have seen in all our tutorials, we will start by outlining the sunflower drawing that we had created with the extremely dark purple shade that we create by mixing the red and the blue. Not any specific shade of red or blue, just mix any red and blue, and whatever shade you get after mixing those colors, use that for outlining the entire sunflower drawing that we made over here before getting started with painting over it. And once again, I would like to tell you that we don't use any black color for our outline, because the black does not blend with all the other colors when the painting is done. It just stands out and does not look good. That's why we do not use any black shade to outline the painting. We create this shade because this dark purple color just blends so amazingly with all the other colors, and you know, it stands out just a bit, just as much as we want it to stand out, and you know, as much as we want it to pop out, give a little bit outline to whatever we have created, and it even blends so well. So you know, that's why this is the color that we use for the outline. So to paint the sunflower over here, I am using some really bright lemon yellow color along with white, and I am using the wet on wet technique. Hi Michelle, I hope that you have seen the last two videos where I taught wet on wet and all the other techniques two different times. So I hope you have watched the video before coming to this video. And for everyone else, I am hoping that by now and by this video, you know what wet on wet technique is. And if you don't, I wanted to refer the previous two videos once again, but I'm sure you know it was one of the most easiest techniques, so I'm sure that you must be all knowing about it. So let's get started with this. So for painting the leaves of the sunflowers, I'm just using some wet on wet technique over here with some yellow color and white color. So on the bottom part of the leaf, I am painting it with yellow color, and on the top part of the leaf, I am painting it with some white color. And while the yellow and white are still wet, I'm just quickly blending them together without using any water. There is no water used in this blending of leaves at all. I'm just wiping my brush. If I want a clean brush for mixing the two colors, I'm just wiping my brush with a rough cloth and then doing the blending thing, but I'm not using any water at all. You have to be really quick with this technique because you want to mix both the colors while yellow and white, both of them are wet. the leaves that are peeking out from the back side of the main leaves. As you can see, I am not giving any shading to them at all. I am just putting on one coat of yellow color on those leaves. So there is no technique involved in the leaves that I used on the back side. It's just plain coloring, nothing else. So now that we are done with doing the yellow color of our sunflower, I am using some orange color, and with that light orange color I am making thin, very thin lines on the petals of the sunflower and spreading that orange color a bit around the center circle. As you can see, this is giving the sunflower a bit of realistic texture that the sunflowers actually have on those leaves. Or maybe, sorry, on their petals. Check out all the droplets that we had thrown on the background using the pink and the white. Check out how amazingly they are peeking out from the petals of the sunflowers. You know, they are peeking from below the petals of the sunflower, and it's making the sunflower look so cool. So, you know, this is exactly what I had imagined before starting the painting, that I wanted the droplets of the pink and white to, you know, peek out from the sunflower. I have this round brush that my son uses for his painting and stuff like that, for making a mess and all that. He got this brush from a really cheap paint that we get for kids. This brush, we got it free with that. So this is a really hard bristle round brush and not smooth like my synthetic hair artist brush at all. So I will be using this brush to make really rough textures in the center of the sunflower. As you can see, I have some brown, shimmery, iridescent brown bronze color over here, and I am just dipping this brush in that bronze color without using any water. And with the stippling technique that you can see over here, I am just going around the center center of that sunflower with that brush. I'm not using any smooth strokes of the painting that I usually used. I'm just using some stippling kind of technique, and with the same brush I take some white and stipple that white on the center of that sunflower. So just in case if you don't have any such brush in your collection, then you can just use plain round synthetic hair brush, you know, maybe number 6 round synthetic hair brush, and use some bronze or brown color, and you know, make dots all around, little dots all around the center of the sunflower, stippling kind of dot.
Thank you.
that we are done with the painting of our sunflowers, let's get on to painting the leaves. Now for painting the leaves, the colors that I am using is one dark shade of green and then one extreme light shade of green, and then I am using some more turquoise blue that I am using as a medium shade of green over here. So first I outline the leaf with the darkest shade of green, and I take the medium shade of green, I apply that between the dark shade that I had painted, and again with wet on wet technique and with the same brush without taking any water, I'm just blending the medium green and the dark green. Now on the upper part of the leaf, I am using the same technique, but instead of the dark green and the medium green, I am using the lighter shade of green with the medium green. And all this I am doing again with only wet on wet technique, and I'm blending the colors when the colors are wet themselves without using any water at all. So now in this other leaf, I am doing it a bit differently. First, I take the darkest green and spread it around the outline of the leaf, and then I take the medium green and paint it in between the leaf, blending it nicely using the wet on wet technique, blending it nicely with the outer dark green that we had colored. And then to increase the highlight on this leaf, I just take some light green in the same brush, you know, wiping the brush in between with my rough cloth. I take the light green and blend it lightly on the same leaf on its upper part, so that is increasing the highlight of the leaf. So these are the two different ways that I have painted all the leaves. And then with the same brush, I am even taking some dark green color and, you know, making thin ventricles of the leaves on them. And with the same technique, we will be coloring all the other leaves as well. We will be, you know, first outlining the leaves with the dark color, and then with the medium green, we will be painting the center part of the leaf and blending them together with the wet on wet technique, and then going on top of it with the light green color to give it some, to give them some highlight. So this is the way you will be blending all the leaves. So now that we are done with our sunflower painting, let's go ahead and see what we want to do further. Till this point, I had no idea that what I wanted to do further, but this sunflower painting did not look complete to me, you know. It seemed like, you know, it needed something more if I wanted to convert it into a journal. So, you know, journals are something that I use for expressing myself and storing my ideas and my thoughts and all that stuff. I wanted to call this journal as my song. And then after a bit of brainstorming and thinking, I decided that why don't I just add a bird who is singing? That'll be so beautiful and cute on the cover of the journal, or as the cover of my journal, as I had named this journal as my song, which is my song. So that bird can represent me and my singing and my thoughts in this journal. So, you know, this idea seemed perfect to me, and I went ahead and decided to draw a bird first on a rough paper, and then I would transfer it over here. So that is exactly what I'm doing over here. I have a rough paper in my hand and I will be drawing a drawing of this bird that we will be painting further. Now over here, to draw the drawing of this bird, I had used a reference photograph that I had googled from the internet. But if you can draw a bird of your imagination, please go ahead and feel free to paint any kind of bird you like. But over here in this journal, because we are making this bird, I will be showing you the completely in slow motion how I am drawing this bird. So although the drawing of this bird will be available as a PDF for you to just download and just, you know, copy it and put it on your painting, it is available as a PDF over here. But just in case you would like to try drawing it yourself, you can just watch this video in slow motion of how I am drawing it, because I am drawing it in a very easy way. This is a very, very simple, easy bird that is very simple to draw, and I am sure that each and every one of you is capable of drawing this bird. So try not to use my PDF to just, you know, trace the bird. Just, you know, while I'm drawing this bird, pause this video, go and bring your journal of rough squares or any sketchbook that you must be having. Bring a pencil and a rubber with you, and along with me, try drawing this bird. Look at the way I'm drawing and try drawing it in your journal. That will be a lot of fun. And after watching this video, after you're done watching this video, if you drew the drawing of the sunflowers as well as the bird, please share it on the special Facebook page that is our Additional's Patreon family page. Do share it over there on our group. So I would love to check out what you came up with or your versions of the drawing, as we are drawing the sunflowers and the birds together. So after I was done drawing the drawing of this bird, I tried to trace it using a carbon paper on my paste sunflower painting, but it was not ready to transfer at all. So what I did is I just redrew it using a white Uniball Signo gel pen on my journal cover page or my sunflower painting again. Check out this beautiful, amazing, glittery painting brush which I'll be using to paint my brush. I have made this brush myself. So let's get back to the painting. Coming back to the painting again, for the bird, I will be using a shade of pink, a really light shade of yellow, and some white. Over here, I am painting the stomach of the bird, as you can see, with white. And I'll be using the wet on wet technique again on the entire bird, and on the part of the tail side I am just using some pink, and with the same round number 12 synthetic hair brush I am mixing the pink and the white. And again on the head, again I'm going with the pink, at the same time slowly blending it with my white using the wet on wet technique. And on the beak of the bird, on the outer part of the beak of the bird, I am again using the same pink. And on the inner part of the bird, I will be using some dark shade because I want that beak to stand out. Next, on the feather of the bird, I am again using the pink shade, as you can see over here, with a little bit of light yellow on the outer feathers of the bird. And then without using any water at all, I am quickly blending the light yellow with the pink on the feathers, and I am just wiping my brush in between with a rough cloth. And once again, I'm not using any water at all. Now again, I am using the same pink to give a bit of outline, thin outlines on the feathers, as you can see. And on the tail of the bird, again I am using same pink only, and a little bit of light yellow to just give some shading on the feathers. taking some dark blue, that is some ultramarine blue, with the same round brush, round synthetic hair brush, directly from the tube, and adding the darker portions of the bird, that is the inside part of the beak and the eye. I'm giving some lines and textures to the feathers and the tail as well. Next, I use a permanent marker that we use to write something on DVDs or CDs, or the marker that can write on any surface. Next, I use that permanent marker to give some texture in black color, the feather-like texture on the stomach of the bird, as you can see, and some more texture on the feather and the tail as well. On top of it, I again go over the bird, adding some more texture using my white Signo gel pen that worked really amazingly on a canvas as well. And with this pen, this white pen, I gave some texture on the bird's head, you know, as if, you know, the some realistic feather-like textures on the head of the bird and on the feathers of the bird as well. I am really in love with this, the way this bird has turned out to be. It is exactly what I had imagined, and it is exactly what I wanted. So I'm really happy with the way the entire cover has turned out to be, and I'm so proud of it. If I would have not converted this cover into a journal, I would have definitely got it framed, and I would have had it as a painting in my home. And you can as well do the same. If you don't want to make a journal, if you don't want a journal for yourself, please feel free to reproduce this painting on a canvas and then have it hanging on your wall. Or you can even gift this painting. You can even make this super simple and very easy painting, and you can even gift it as a Christmas gift to maybe your mom, to maybe your friend, or anybody who is very dear to you in your life. So now that our painting is ready on our canvas cloth, let's get on with the binding of our journal. So over here, I will be doing the Midori style binding. That is, I will not be stitching the papers onto this journal, but I will be making three loops, and I will be attaching my papers in those three loops. First, let's get started with the binding. So first, fold your journal into two halves like this and create a center line. Now, using a scale, I measured the center, and from the center I marked two dots on the right side of the center as well as on the left side of the center, and the distance between the two dots on the right side and the left side of the center dot is just 0.5 centimeter. That is 0.5 centimeter, and I will be repeating the same three dots on the top part of the journal as well as on the bottom part of the journal. And the dots on the top part of the journal are just 0.5 inch away from the top. The dots on the bottom part of the journal are again just 0.5 inch away from the bottom part. Now, using something really very sharp, or you know, something that is easier for you to use to poke holes on, I want you to poke holes on all the dots that we had created.
So, over here, I
decided to use the synthetic elastic thread to bind my Midori style journal. This thread is usually used in jewelry making, but I found this to be absolutely perfect for this binding because I wanted some transparent kind of thread, yet I wanted it to be strong. That's why I used this, because in this journal I did not want the thread to, you know, come over or overpower my journal when I make the closure of it. I wanted something like kind of see-through, like this thread only, so that, you know, when my journal is complete, even with the closure, my journal stands out and not the thread. So if you would like to know the exact thread that I used over here, then I will put it as a photographs in the PDFs down below. So don't forget to check that out. And because this thread is so transparent, unfortunately it is not very visible on the camera, and that's why, you know, I tried to record it's the narration of how I am doing the binding, but it was getting very difficult because I'm not able to show you exactly what I'm doing because of the transparency of this thread. That's why I am sharing with you one of the videos of my very, very dear friend. Her name is Zaira Benez and she's from Australia, and she has the YouTube video on exactly how to do this binding. So to know exactly how I'm doing this binding for my Midori, do check out Zaira's YouTube video again, whose link I will put in the down bar below. So now that the binding spines of our sketchbook is ready, we will start adding papers to this journal of ours. So as I showed you earlier, in the first part of the journal I wanted to have some sketchbook paper, so I had this spare sketchbook and it was too large in size, and it was very difficult for me to use it on a daily basis. So over here I am cutting out some papers from that sketchbook, and then I will measure the size of my journal and cut these sketchbook papers according to the size of my journal, fold them into two halves, and then insert them in one of the spines of my journal. That way the first part of my journal, that was the part where I only wanted to do the sketching and stuff, will be ready. Similarly, I had a spare sketchbook that had a lot of watercolor papers in it, and those were very good quality, and I was not using that journal on a regular basis. So to make the watercolor part for my journal, I took out some pages from that and folded them, cut them, and stuck them in the second spine of this journal to have a part where I wanted to concentrate more on painting rather than sketching. And on the third part again, I had a spare lined notebook, and that was half full and half empty, so I took out half empty pages out of it and again folded them and made the third part of this journal by adding them in the third spine of this journal. So again, how I created these three spines of this Midori style journal that I made, I'm so extremely sorry that because of using the transparent thread, I was not able to, you know, show you clearly how I did that. So I found a YouTube video that could explain to you with a clear black thread. So that's why I shared with you that video. I'm very sad that I was not able to explain to you myself, but I hope you will understand, and I really hope that you enjoyed the painting, and I hope that you will try making this painting at home.
enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, because your thumbs up makes me be sure that each and every one of you have seen this tutorial. So, you know, go to the YouTube video where this is posted and give this video a thumbs up. It gives a satisfaction to my soul that, you know, each and every one of you have seen it. So, you know, I need 9 thumbs ups over there if you enjoyed this tutorial. And do let me know in the comments below that if you liked it or not, and if you were able to understand the colors, and if you were okay that I took it to the next level and I made you think. And since this is a kind of simpler tutorial compared to the Buddha and the Flower Girl, I would be really waiting for you to come up with your versions of it, you know. And one more thing that I forgot to tell you is this: you can just make this painting on a canvas. Of course, you can give that canvas as a Christmas present to somebody, or if you want, you can make this painting and you can take the photograph of it, and you can have that photograph made into some beautiful Christmas cards. Like around the beak of the bird, you can like write Merry Christmas or something like that. You can even convert this painting into beautiful cards as a Christmas gift to your friends and family, or whatever occasion you celebrating. Or you can, you know, convert this into special birthday cards that you can use all year round for your friends, family and colleagues and all those people. So do try this painting, simple painting at home, and do convert it into many other things that you can. And if you want, you can use even my image that I am selling on Etsy. No, you don't have to buy my image. You, as my patrons, are very special to me, and I wanted to give a special gift to each and every one of you for actually watching my tutorials and supporting me the way you do. As a special gift for that, you know, I wanted to give away something that I can. So I am giving away this complete full resolution high quality image of this painting that I will post as a PDF below, and you can use the image of this painting wherever you want. Like, you can get cards made out of it, you can get canvas reproductions made out of it, you can get Christmas cards made out of it, you can get cell phone cases made out of it, gift to your family and friends. So you can do a lot with the PDF that I am giving away. So this is a special thanks from my side to you all for being there for me and supporting me so much. This is a thanks from the bottom of my heart. So let me announce who's the winner of the giveaway. All your artworks were perfect, like Annette, Robin and Jeanette, all your artworks were perfect and I love them. But depending on the technical aspects of art, like how the way you used paints, how your colors were, if you completed your painting or not, the effort, the amount of efforts you took and all that, depending on all these categories, congratulations Jeanette, you are the winner of this month's giveaway. Yay! I am so excited, Jeanette. You are the underdog who keeps saying, "Oh, I don't know how to paint. I have this, I have this problem, I have that problem. I cannot paint, I cannot draw." You are that underdog who just keeps saying that, and you came up with such a beautiful painting that is unbelievable. I mean, not unbelievable, but that was like a surprise. You know, somebody just keeps saying all the time, "I cannot draw, I cannot paint, I cannot do this," and boom, you throw this amazing artwork on my face. And I was like, what? That was a very pleasant surprise. So congratulations, Jeanette. You are the winner of our giveaway. And do send me your address and I will send you the Buddha bag ASAP, as soon as possible. So do stay tuned for the next tutorial where I will be bringing you some special holiday giveaway treats as well. So I will be giving away something special for the holidays as a special Christmas gift for you all. So till I see you next time, bye and happy creating. Bye.